What's up, YouTube? It's been a minute.
Where it's at? This is where it's at. Points on the scoreboard, boy, you got it in the bag. On the rack, fresh up on the rack. Big bass in the chart, so you know it's finna snap. It's a fact, hold the jack, let me call you back. Run it back, double tap, ooh, I'm loving that. Feeling right, yeah, I'm feeling right. This is how you feel, I like to keep it tight. What it do, what it is. We party just like this. Uh-huh, just like this.
What's going on, everybody? I just got back from Oshkosh. It was an amazing time. One of the funnest things I've ever done. I'll definitely be going back next year. And I gotta mow the airstrip real quick. And I have a couple of friends stopping by today. My buddy Troy Brown is bringing his Kit Fox 1 out here to 7-Up Ranch so I can see it. Haven't seen it yet. It has the TK1 gear on it already, which that's where mine is at Stoll Creek Aviation, getting the TK1 gear. Super excited. And my buddy Michael and his wife are gonna come by. They're on their way back from flying down in Arkansas. Let's go mow real quick and check out their airplanes. Come on.
See me in a little while. I've been holding back for the right time. I feel so brand new, all new me, like a reboot. You might have heard through the grapevine, good things in the pipeline. I came to make a move. Better watch next what I'm gonna do.
And it's camo. Everything is cool camo. Howdy, Troy. I like the Kit Fox.
Thank you.
What model is it?
One.
It's a one?
Yeah.
This is nice.
Thank you.
You're enjoying it, aren't you?
Yeah, it's a lot of fun.
What do you think about that gear?
That was made the landing okay, because I come in kind of high.
Yeah.
Once they mow it, it's hard to see it.
Right, right.
So, I'm like, is that a hay bale out there? So I kind of did. But anyway, yeah.
This is a nice Kit Fox. I love. Did you add the landing light right there?
No, it was on there when I got it. I haven't really done anything to it. This is how I got it. But yeah, I'm having a lot of fun with it.
My fuel truck arrived.
Sweet.
Yeah,
how you doing?
Good to see you. I've heard all this good stuff about you.
Yeah, well, I don't know what it was you heard.
Yeah, it was good.
Yeah, well, as long as it's good.
Is that a good shirt or what?
That's awesome. Yeah, that's
man, they don't need much runway. Brandon doesn't.
Well, no. They're pretty dang good pilots.
Yeah.
I couldn't be. I'm not that good.
I can't believe they hit the brakes that hard. And
they don't hit them too hard because they'll nose up.
Go tell all your friends. I'm bad. You can't keep me away. You know we're going to celebrate every day because I'm bad. Yeah. I got all eyes on me. I got fire in my feet. You better believe it.
Time to get back to work. Dad brought me my gas. Troy stopped by to see us. Now I gotta finish mowing.
show you how to do the move. Made it to the landing strip.
Everybody move and clap your hands, cause I am back again. Left, right, to the left, I'ma turn it up into the red. Everybody move and clap your hands, cause I am back again. I know what I came for.
It's hot out here. Mowing's finished. Let's go move some hay bales and wait on Mike and his wife to get here. I want to see the Piper Payson do a flyby.
You can't keep me away. You know we're gonna celebrate every day, cause I'm back. Yeah.
What's going on, crew? How are you?
Good. That should stay there.
Nice flyover.
Thanks, man.
How are you? I'm David.
Gabby, nice.
Nice to meet you, Gabby. Yeah. How are the winds? How you doing, bud?
Not bad. They're calm. Calm, dude.
Yeah.
Man, it strip's looking nice.
It looks pretty good, huh?
That grass looks out there.
Good to see you, brother. What engine do you have in this?
Lycoming 0360.
Is it?
Yeah, 180 horse.
Nice.
It looks good. As inches as you get.
And you have the bush wheels. That's oh, these are the Alaskan bush wheels, aren't they?
Yeah, they're Alaskan.
Yeah. So I have the Airstream. So this 31s.
31s.
Yeah. Nice, man. Michael, showing us how it's done here, man. Yeah. Plane looks good. Piper Pacer, isn't it?
Yeah. It used to be a Tri-Pacer. Yeah. Then it got converted to a.
Well, all right, well, you guys be careful going back.
Right,
thanks,
man,
for stopping by. Yep. Hey, it's good to meet you. Take care.
Itself right there.
Hey, thanks again for stopping by, Michael.
Yep. See ya.
Appreciate it. Y'all have a safe flight home. Ha ha, I love that airplane. Well, that was super cool. Mike and his wife stopped by. I haven't met her yet. Expecting their first baby in September. So, super nice of him. They're on their way back from a fly-in down in Arkansas. So, that was nice. That's one of our flying buddies. All right, today's the big day. Heading out to Wichita to get my airplane. Can't wait to see that TK1 gear. Brandon just got here, just landed. He's gonna give me a ride out there. We're gonna fly it home. Got a fun little adventure playing on the way home too.
Prop clear.
made it out here to Stoll Creek to pick up my plane, and it looks good. Look at this. Oh, yeah. Well, it's officially a bush plane, finally. Been wanting to do this for so long.
This guy right here did it all.
He's too busy.
I came out 2 weeks ago and like unscrewed two bolts. That's all I was good for. Michael, hey, thank you. It looks good. I love it.
You came out and wore your back out.
I did. I couldn't walk for 2 days.
The funny thing is Dave's like, oh, I got plenty of gas out there for you.
Yeah. Guess what?
Now I'm all... We're good.
You don't want to smell some gas fumes the whole way home?
Mm-mm.
I officially have a Stoll airplane. Thank you so much, man.
Yeah.
Looks good. I really appreciate it. I love it. Brandon's been hounding me for like a year to get a TK1 gear in.
No, that's going to be awesome.
I needed the push.
Yeah.
Now I'm in the club.
Now you need some horsepower and a prop.
I wish you could make it. So keep me posted if you can.
Okay.
It'd be awesome. It?
Like how many kiddos you got?
About 7.
Oh, how old are they from what range?
14 to 2.
Where? All right, let's do some taxi testing and check out these brakes. Oh yeah, I like it. These brakes aren't too stiff, too. I can push. Oh, they're set up perfect. They aren't too touchy, they're not too mushy. Love this setup. Stoll Creek Aviation, look them up. I'll put the info below. Michael's a great guy, does a great job. Stoll Creek traffic at Fox 4959, departing to the east, Stoll Creek.
I'm gonna switch over there.
130.3.
I'm up.
El Dorado traffic, hitbox 4959 on final. Runway 4, full stop, El Dorado. El Dorado traffic, hitbox 4959, go around El Dorado. So my airplane sits a lot taller now, so I need to flare a little bit sooner. It's all about feel with this new gear.
10, El Dorado. Traffic tip box 4959's on final, runway 4, El Dorado. I like it. I like it a lot. Dude, that thing is like night and day having this gear.
Yeah, you need a little bit more air pressure. I think you're probably down around 5 or so. I don't know.
My first one, I came in and I flared a little bit too late because I'm used to being shorter to the ground.
Yeah.
So I went around and then I was all the way back on the stick. I thought I was going to, and it just sat down. And
piece of cake.
It was a piece of cake. It's cushion. Yeah. TK1,
like
I am, dude. I'm shaking. Look at this.
Will you?
You want to back taxi a little bit?
Yeah. According to the wind sock, let's back taxi to same way I came in.
El Dorado traffic. Grand 90, 02 kilos. Departing runway 4. Be a right turn out to the southeast. El Dorado.
That tail flying. Get that baby off. Okay, so we just stopped in El Dorado, Kansas to grab some more. Brandon needed to top off. And now we're going to Beaumont. It's a little grass. It's actually a really long, nice grass strip. It's real close to here.
Today I'm going 122.9.
Real old water tower. Everybody takes their picture in front of this water tower and a restaurant and a...
I'm going to switch over. It's 122.9, I believe.
Got it. And it's an old restaurant, hotel. But I've always wanted to fly to this place. Oh, and they used to have Barry Seals, one of his airplanes on display. Or just sitting out there by the water tower, one of his actual planes. If you've never seen the movie American Made, you need to go check it out. It's awesome. One of my favorite movies based on a true story of Barry Seal. Have to watch it. So we're going to do a landing there. Beaumont traffic, hitbox 4959 final. 36, full stop. A little bit uphill. I'm just not used to this gear. I actually stuck that landing. But I didn't think I stuck it, so I went full power.
Davey, keep your crosswind correction in all the way.
Brandon's right, you gotta keep that left wing down. That's why he's my flying buddy. That was a little gusty crosswind. Ooh, I didn't like that.
All right, that was a challenge. It's a little gusty today, but we made it to Beaumont, the famous water tower. Barry Seal's airplane. We'll go check that out here in just a second. All right, we're gonna grab some lunch and then get back in the air, head back to Pittsburgh. Oh, have me a good BLT. Now we need a nap. We have about another 50-minute flight back to Pittsburgh. Check Beaumont off the list.
I got a sweet plane right there. Nice kit box.
Appreciate it, fellas. Your bathroom breaks are a little easier than mine.
That's true.
Y'all have a good one.
I say.
All right, so we need to climb up to 7,500 feet because below that, there's a major headwind, like 14, 15 knots, so we're going to climb up there.
Right here, all right, we got four left positive track out back, 750 double bumper, Edelbrock intake, board over 30, 11 to 1 pop-up piston, turbojet, 390 horsepower, we're talking some muscle.
That's good. Is that off Dazed and Confused?
Yeah, I won my fave, 1993.
Reminds me of the Joe Dirt firecracker scene. You're gonna stand there on a fireworks stand, tell me you don't got no mud slingers, no screaming mimmies, no whisper biscuits, no hoosker dudes or hoosker don'ts, with or without the scooter stick. Thank you.
But hey.
Yeah, this year it just lands so much easier. I mean, I need to get used to when I need to flare, but I love it. I love it.
Yeah, it's pretty awesome.
An insurance policy.
Yeah, they're awesome, dude.
Yeah, it's amazing.
Got the Behringers on there.
Just need to get used to it, but it's definitely so much better, man. Like, I came in, I had a, 8-knot headwind, and I came in, and I flared at 50, and I floated down the runway just a little bit, and it just sat down, and then I stopped within, 60 feet. I'm like, golly.
The brakes are awesome, ain't they?
They're unbelievable.
You just pull a stick back. And
yeah. To cut power, you know, right when I flared, it's nice. I love it.
Hell yeah. Hey, neighbor. Come here and check out my new setup.
You happy with it?
Oh, I love it. It's unbelievable. It's night and day.
Is that right?
From what it used to do on that.
Why'd you actually change?
So I changed this whole landing gear.
But I didn't know. Did you make a difference, I'll say? Or did you just put it back
where it was? So we took that Grove gear off.
Okay.
And then put this whole new system right here on it with shocks.
Okay.
And the Behringer wheels, tires, the brakes are—I mean, it's night and day.
Yeah.
So Brandon brought his old prop. You see this?
Right. Oh man.
So this prop's like 10 years old. So we're gonna see if his old prop that he had on there will work on here. So we're getting ready to take it apart and work on it.
Sure.
So what kind of prop is this?
Warp drive.
Warp drive. That's so much better than mine.
Well, we can tune it for your plane. That's what's badass. We'll have to measure in and pick a spot, see how that levels.
Mm-hmm.
So that's level right there. God, I hate those. And you're at 4.9.
Okay.
Pitch.
And what do you want it?
Oh, we'll have to go up to probably, I'd say 14.
Yeah.
I'd say. Davey got him. We're going to try a new prop here, bub.
All right.
So we'll go out here. Up here 52, 54, 56.
But I can't go full power because the brakes.
They won't hold? That's weird.
Yeah, I mean, I'm only this far to be at full power.
Looking good, looking better.